Hello my dear students, welcome back to my channel. In this session I'll be continuing with the gene interactions. So gene interactions are of two types: interallelic interactions and intergeneric interactions. Interallelic is between two different alleles, that is, it can be a dominant allele and recessive allele. That is called as an interallelic interaction. And intergenic interaction is between the two different genes or two different characters, that is called as a intergeneric interaction. So now we are going to do with what is interallelic interaction. So interallelic interaction, in that the first part we will do is the modified ratios, monohybrid ratio. We will do about modified monohybrid ratio. Modified monohybrid ratio. We all know in Mendel's monohybrid cross, the monohybrid ratios are phenotypic. If we consider phenotypic, it is 3:1, and genotypic is 1:2:1. These are the normal ratios. But in some conditions, these ratios are modified. They are called as modified ratios. So first we will see what is the modified 1:2:1 ratio. Modified 1:2:1 ratio. So here we will say these are of three different types. These modified ratios we will discuss under three different headings. They are three different types. The first one, I'll first list down what are the three different types and then we will discuss one by one. So first one is incomplete dominance. First type is called as incomplete dominance. The second is codominance, and the third one is heterodominance, or this is also called as over dominance. So these are the three different types of these modified 1:2:1 ratio. So first I will start with incomplete dominance. Let us start with incomplete dominance first. Here we will do with the examples. I will start with examples. So first type, incomplete dominance. In incomplete dominance, in heterozygous condition, when any character is in heterozygous condition, remember these are the modified monohybrid ratios. So when any character is in heterozygous condition, so in incomplete dominance, both the alleles, both the characters will express themselves. When both are expressed themselves, a totally different phenotype is obtained. That is what is called as an incomplete dominance. So example, first example is in case of Mirabilis, which is commonly also called 4-o'clock plant. It is also commonly called as 4-o'clock plant. The second example is Snapdragon. This is common name. Snapdragon is common name. Its scientific name, Antirrhinum majus. Scientific name is Antirrhinum majus. Here in both these cases, the flower color will show incomplete dominance. Flower color can show incomplete dominance. The third example is feather color in Andalusian fowls. hen-like animal. Fowls are hen-like animals, hen-like birds. And feather color in Andalusian fowls. So, these three examples we are going to discuss now. So, in Mirabilis and Snapdragon, we find the flower color. So, here, flower color, red color is dominant over white. Red color is dominant over white. Suppose we take red as capital R, white as small r, we get R, that is heterozygous condition. So normally if it is a Mendel's monohybrid, we should get only the phenotype of the dominant parent, but here we don't get the phenotype of neither of the parents. The phenotype is completely different. So here we get pink color of the flowers. So that is called as the incomplete dominance, because both are being expressed together. So it is called as an incomplete dominance. There is a blending of characters here. Both the alleles are expressed. That means there is a blending of characters. The pigments which are produced, they mix with each other. So they give a totally a different color. So blending is seen, which is deviation from the Mendel's observation. Now, this is in case of, say this is F1 generation. Suppose we observe F2 generation. F2 generation ratio, you know, 1:2:1. This is a genotypic ratio. Here we get red, pink and white in this ratio. So red will be capital R, pink will be R, and white will be r. So here we are getting three different phenotypes. So here phenotypic genotypic ratio is same. So this 1:2:1 here is, it is both phenotypic as well as genotypic ratio. It is both phenotypic as well as genotypic ratio. So there is no distinction between a phenotypic and genotypic ratio in case of incomplete dominance. So this is the example of both Mirabilis Snapdragon. We can take the same cross. Now, the third example we take in case of Andalusian fowls. So here in Andalusian fowls, here the feather color. The example taken here is the feather color. So dominant color is a black color crossed with recessive color white. So black color and white color. So an intermediate color is obtained in heterozygous condition, that is the blue color. An intermediate condition is observed in heterozygous condition. Intermediate color, that is called as a blue color. And in F2, this blue color, all blue we find in F1. Suppose we observe in case of F2. So we get 1:2:1 ratio in F2 condition. And this will be black, blue and white. Black, blue and white. So here also we get the similar result. It will be 1:2:1, both phenotypic and genotypic ratio. So this is what are the examples of incomplete dominance. Now let us see